When it comes to people's opinions on movies, we live in an era of extremes. A film is either the best thing ever, or it's an abomination that any right-minded human should be ashamed of liking. But when it comes down to it, what exactly makes those bad films worthy of that hate? One clunky performance, a handful of cheesy lines, a smattering of familiar plot points? And perhaps more importantly, is there found beneath that egregious element something missed? Something good, something actually worth our time. Maybe, maybe not. But let's find out together. Welcome to Film Negative. I'm sure most of us can agree that the Mission Impossible franchise as a whole really is fantastic, extremely entertaining and expertly crafted. But when it comes to the entries that receive the most vocal praise, Brad Bird's Ghost Protocol and Christopher McQuarrie's Rogue Nation and Fallout seem to be the ones that most often walk home with those prizes, and deservedly so. The Burj Khalifa scene alone is a masterclass in how to shoot an action sequence, the opera scene would do Hitchcock himself proud, and Cruise deserves at least a couple of medals for actually accomplishing a helicopter stunt that pilots with decades of experience thought was, you guessed it, impossible. So today, I would like to shine a spotlight on the often forgotten middle child installment, J.J. Abrams' MI3. And it's clear, actionable, noble objectives like this, along with truly dynamic tactics that our heroes implement to achieve them, that makes this film worth that second look. Mission Impossible, what a great franchise to delve into. I've got to ask you guys, which of the films is your favorite in the series? For me personally, it's actually Mission Impossible 4, Ghost Protocol. Per usual, I must also ask you, what other films do you want me to explore in this series? And if there's any specific scenes in those films, I'd love to hear about those as well. Until next time though, guys, I'm Chris Hartwell, and this was Film Negative. Cheers.